the boards. Andrew Ladd checked by Coburn. Campbell holds the puck into the line. Turns, won't shoot. Kane watched by Kimo Tiivanen to the net. Lennon stopped it. Where's the puck? It came loose on the other side. It's over. Patrick Kane has scored the goal. The Chicago Blackhawks' long drought is over. For the first time since 1961, the Chicago Blackhawks have won the Stanley Cup.
Can't find the puck.
Far side, guys. Yeah, wait, far side of the net, bounce.
And there it is.
There's the puck. What a remarkable end to a remarkable game, and what a season.
Let's watch as the puck goes through Layton and right in the corner. Wow, got stuck underneath the netting. Layton thought he had it. The only guy who saw it was that man, Patrick Kane.
And they had to break up the pile and then start another one when they made sure that the puck had been found. Silence in Philadelphia, and all of the fans are still here, shocked that this incredible journey of their Flyers has finally come to an end. And the young Blackhawks, favored by many, have won the Stanley Cup.
And the crowd finally getting official word now that it's a goal. Watch Kane as he's the one who took the shot. Little juke and jive here as he's done so effectively. Gets outside position, and then once he saw it going around, there's his reaction. No hesitation from him whatsoever as he lives every young boy's dreams. Stan Bowman looking on, looking where the puck is. Everybody realizing what has finally happened.
So ironic too, eh? The gold medal from that same spot, Canada wins it. And Patrick Kane from that same spot wins his team the Stanley Cup.
15th time in the history of this great trophy that the cup-winning goal has been scored in overtime. And Patrick Kane gets it just like Mush Marsh did for Chicago in 1934. And the celebration is on in the Windy City.